Hey, good afternoon. First of all, I'd like to welcome everybody to this pep talk this afternoon. Please mute yourself but always show your video pictures. Sign in your name, your Facebook account, or email address in the chat box. Please include the names of companions attending with you. Use the chat box to ask questions and make comments while the pep talk is on. There will be group pictures at the start and end of the pep talk, so please show your beautiful faces in the video. A reminder is that after the pep talk, please take the online learning comp evaluation test exercise or OLETE for mastery of learning and have a perfect score to get a certificate like the one shown here. Breast cancer, when to suspect. I have placed the link in the chat box. Another reminder, obtaining 25 OLETE certificates, meaning after getting a perfect score, you get an OLETE certificate, and obtaining 25 OLETE certificates will entitle one mentee to a free voucher for a RO Hoson medical consultation, either face-to-face or telemedical. Another request, please type in your feedback in the chat box during the open forum and before we adjourn. Let's now have a group picture taking before we start the pep talk proper in 2 minutes. Please turn on your video and show your faces. Ready? One, two, three. I have a patient empowerment program in which I would like to empower the lay people or patients to take control in the management of their health. I started with Pep Talk on May 15, 2021, during the COVID-19 pandemic. There are three courses in the Pep Talk. I completed the core course on October 9, 2021. And from October 23, 2021 onwards, I have been tackling health disorder and health issue.
Doc, sorry po, your voice is breaking po.
Okay. Can you hear? Okay. You cannot hear me now? Can you hear me?
We can hear you po, pero ano, nagbe-break po yung voice niyo. Parang on and off.
On and off. Baka yung signal. Okay. How do I... How about now?
Better po.
Better? I think...
Okay naman, Jo. Yes, okay naman po.
Baka yung signal na nagpa-fluctuate. Okay. So,
thank you.
Okay. So, feel free to interrupt me anytime if you have a problem hearing me. No? From October 2023, 2021 onwards, I've been tackling health disorder and health issue courses. May 18, 2024, this year marks the start of the year 4 of the RO Hoson Pep Talks. How long the pep talk will last will depend on our enthusiasm, discipline, perseverance, both you and me. My pep talk today is entitled Breast Cancer, When to Suspect. I'd like to have this empowerment objective is for the lay people to have an essential understanding on breast cancer, when to suspect as part of their health management. I thought of this topic because I see a lot of patients coming to me at a stage of far advanced stage already. Okay, it's either they don't recognize they have breast cancer or they just refuse to accept that they have breast cancer. The contents of this particular pep talk this afternoon will be the following: when to suspect presence of breast cancer after a breast self-exam. So kayo ang gagawa, breast self-exam, after a physician physical exam, after an ultrasound, and after a mammography. Ultrasound and mammography are the two most commonly used diagnostic procedures for patients with breast concerns. Then the second big topic will be, what are the confirmatory diagnostic procedures that can be done after suspicion for a breast cancer? So after a breast self-examination, what can be done after? After a physician physical exam, what can be done after? And after an imaging procedure such as ultrasound and mammography. So these are the two main topics that I will cover this afternoon. A disclaimer, the R.O. Hosson Pep Talk contains my thoughts, perceptions, opinions, recommendations culled from experiences of myself and also from the writings of other professionals, which I also read once in a while. So as to the first big topic, when to suspect presence of breast cancer. So first, after a breast self-examination. So when you say breast self-examination, kayo muna ang gagawa ng examination of the breast. Okay. So one starts suspecting the possible presence of breast cancer in oneself, in one breast, if one noted the following. So usually, ang first clue, ang pinakamabigat na clue dito, usually a solid breast mass and non-tender. Okay. I will explain this word solid later on. Okay. So usually, meron isang bukol na solid and then hindi siya masakit. So yan ang first clue. Usually, that's the first clue, the most common starting point. So the most common starting point for suspecting a breast cancer after your breast self-examination. And kung di nyo ginagawa yung monthly breast self-examination and then there was a breast cancer growing already and becoming bigger and bigger. So if advanced already in the advanced stage of the cancer, there will be skin changes and nipple retraction. Yan ang makikita ninyo sa balat ninyo over the mass, no? Yung may konting nakalubog yung balat, hinihila, o kaya yung nipple, hinihila rin paloob, no? Or the other one, it's when the mass is already fixed and not, or not movable. Hindi siya gumagalaw na. Now, mahirap na i-move around. Okay? So when you say solid, no, solid means most likely it does not contain fluid. Okay? So ididiin lang yung bukol, no, titingnan kung mababaon. Pag diniin nyo kung babaon yung balat doon. No? Kasi kung babaon, most likely may fluid siya and we call that cystic. Okay? So if cystic siya, most likely benign. So wag na kayo matakot, no? But if it's solid, na hindi siya lumulubog, not cystic, okay? Then at hindi pa siya masakit, doon ang nakakatakot. So yan ang unang clue that you have to really consult a breast specialist right away. Okay? So solid breast mass and non-tender. Okay? So non-tender means not painful or no pain upon pressing. Okay? Non-tender breast mass is more worrisome than one with tenderness. So tandaan ninyo, ito, ha? Kasi ito yung palaging baliktad yung pananaw ng mga tao. Hindi siya masakit, eh baliwala siya, mukhang okay naman. Pag masakit naman, takot na takot sila. No? Mabaliktad. No? So, kung masakit siya, mas maganda, pero not always. Kung di siya masakit, doon ang mas nakakatakot. Na? So in a breast self-exam, one has to differentiate between lumpy breast surface and dominant mass. So kadalasan pag kinakapa, we don't know, sasabihin ng mga tao, ay hindi kami marunong kumapa. That's true, it's not easy to kapa, but we have to know how to make kapa and then how to learn it and then so that we will be able to catch the cancer early if it does occur. Okay. So, ito yung drawing that shows ito yung balat. Sa ilalim ng balat, may mga taba dyan. And then after the taba, sa ilalim taba, andyan yung pinaka-breast proper. Okay? Usually, walang distinct boundary between the taba and the breast. Na? At usually, yung outer surface ng breast dito, na? Usually, hindi siya smooth. Okay? Normal lang yan. Okay? Hindi siya smooth to start with. Kasi wala, hindi naman siya straight line, no? Pero kung mayroon mang hormonal changes, no? Or with some aging, so usually yung ibang areas nito mas maumbok is sa ibang areas, no? So we call it humpy, parang hump sa kalye, lumpy, ganun din, no? Okay, humpy lang siya. Okay. So once you have this condition, we call it it's still okay, it's still normal, no? So we call it the humpy breast surface, and therefore we said that it's still normal because no, there's no dominant mass that will incite you to suspect something bad. No? So kung meron ganito, we usually just call it fibrocystic changes or hormonal changes. No? Okay. Or essentially, we call it normal. Normal lang siya. Okay. So yung dominant mass naman, pag may nakapa kayo something like this, as illustrated, a solid mass, no? O kahit na anong mass, solid or cystic, basta dominant mass, ganun din ang sa cystic mass, may dominant mass, basta it's something that is usually three-dimensional, pagkapa, at usually nag-stand out, no? From the surrounding tissue. Pag kinapa nyo yung katabi ng tissues, usually iba ang texture. So pagdating dito, meron siyang talagang bukol, no? Okay. So kung meron nito, yan ang tinatawag na red flag, or let's just call it the real mass, kasi minsan dinidifferentiate natin from the humpy breast. Okay? So pag meron nito, that's the real mass that you have to be concerned with, and then that's why we call it the red flag. When you say red flag, it doesn't mean it's always cancer na, no? It's some red flag just means that it has to be investigated further and as soon as possible. Okay? So dominant mass ang hahanapin natin. Okay? Kung walang dominant mass, ito yon, humpy breast. No? Okay. Again, once you start suspecting the possible presence of breast cancer, if there is a solid, okay, in-explain ko na yung solid, and then non-tender, in-explain ko na rin, okay, breast mass, which is a dominant mass, okay, if palpated. So itong three components, solid, non-tender, dominant mass. Okay. So when to suspect presence of breast cancer naman, after a physician like me who will do the physical examination. Almost the same, may konting dagdag lang because of our expertise. Okay. So one starts suspecting possible presence of breast cancer if one noted the following on the physician physical examination. Again, as I said, solid, non-tender, dominant mass. Okay, so with some more expertise in our hands, no? So kung yung i-define namin kung anong itsura ng dominant mass, kung yung border na yon, hindi maganda yung boundary, it's not distinct from the surrounding tissues, we call that ill-defined border, yan ang starting point of suspecting breast cancer. Okay, kasi kung solid, non-tender, dominant mass lang, no? Okay, so it can still be benign. But the moment we find that the border is ill-defined, not well circumscribed, not regular ang border, hindi siya distinct from the surrounding tissue, yan ang starting point ng suspecting breast cancer. Okay? Usually, with the presence of ill-defined border, solid, non-tender, dominant mass, right away, the suspicion for breast cancer will be 60 at least 60-40 kagad, no? Okay? 60% breast cancer, 40% benign. So pwede pa rin benign kaya 40%, pero mas malamang, mas mabigat yung suspicion na breast cancer. Okay? So this is in the earlier stage of the breast cancer kung wala pang mga skin changes, wala pang lymph node at hindi pa suma at hindi pa fix, no? So in the earlier stages, ito yung binabasihan ng doktor, ng breast specialist, yung ill-defined border. Okay? So, more so, as I said, more at the early stage, more so, kung fix na yung bukol at matigas, and then may invasion, no, kinain na or dilusob na yung overlying skin, resulting in retraction, inakabaon yung balat, nakadikit ng balat, and then nipple retraction, and then kung merong bloody nipple discharge, and then armpit lymph nodes, all the more we suspect breast cancer. So kung meron na itong hard fixation, invasion of skin, nipple retraction, bloody nipple discharge, armpit lymph nodes, then the suspicion for breast cancer is more than 60% na. So kung ill-defined border and hard, probably ang suspecha mo is 70 already, 70 is 30, na? 30 for not breast cancer, so pwede pa rin hard yon, ill-defined na benign siya, no? Pero the moment may ill-defined border, hard and fixed, no? So magiging, probably magiging 90% na ang suspecha for breast cancer. Kung meron ng invasion of the overlying skin, nipple retraction, bloody nipple discharge, no? Mga ano na yan, aabotin ka na 95% ang suspecha na baka breast cancer yung solid non-tender dominant mass. Now, kung may kasamang lymph nodes, nakakapa yung pulani sa kilikili on that side of the breast mass, then the suspect will be, the degree of suspicion will be as high as 98-99% already. Okay? So that's how me, at least me, as a breast specialist, do the evaluation. No? So merong mga certain degree, certain findings that will carry some weight. Kung ill-defined border lang, may konting suspecha, 60%, kung medyo matigas na, no, mga probably 70%, kung may fix na, okay, 90%, kung may invasion, 95, ganon, no, okay, lymph nodes, mga 98-99%. So depending on the stage that we see the patient at, no, well, kung anong findings at that time, no, okay. Kasi yung breast cancer pag sa isang pasyente, it presents at different stages. Yung iba, maaga pa, kaya kung saan medyo mas mahirap i-recognize. Kung medyo malala na, medyo advanced na, like kung may invasion of the skin, madali nang i-diagnose, madali nang i- So, ito yung example ng ito, may skin invasion na, no? Okay, ito rin, makikita niyo just by looking, yung nipples, my skin, naka-retracted na, no? Okay, ito, more so, kinain na yung balat, no? Puput, in a few days or few months, no, few weeks, puputok na ito, no? Okay, so these are telltale signs of breast cancer just by looking suspect breast cancer already, no? Kung smooth ang skin, well, yung bukol na sa ilalim, then we try to determine the border, saka yung hardness, saka fixation, no? Kung meron ng invasion of the skin, kitang-kita na, okay, give away na yon, no, most likely breast cancer na siya, no? Ito naman, another big clue for suspecting breast cancer, may bukol ka regardless of yung mga characteristics, ill-defined border, fixed, o ganon, basta may dugo sa nipple, okay, right away we suspect breast cancer. No? Mataas ang chance of breast cancer. May bukol at may dugo or bloody red nipple discharge. No? Ngayon, sabi ko kanina, axillary lymph nodes, may kulani, no? Okay? May kulani, tapos may breast mass. Kung meron yan, mataas ang suspecha that you are dealing with breast cancer. Okay? As I said, 98-99% yun na yun, no? Now, how about an ultrasound? Pag may mga pasyente na dala-dala ang ultrasound, no? O may pinagawa ng doktor ng ultrasound, so when do you suspect presence of breast cancer sa ultrasound naman? Ito yung a common test being done for patients with breast concern. So once start suspecting possible presence of breast cancer in the ultrasound, wag may nakita sa ultrasound, again, solid. Okay, solid breast mass and irregular margin. Sasabihin niyang yung sonographer, ultrasonographer pagbasa, sabi nila, there is a hypoechoic solid mass with irregular margin. The moment you see those terms, right away, yan ang magiging basihan ng ultrasonographer na basahin na siya na may suspicion for cancer. Usually, they call it BI-RADS 4. Minimum is 4. Pag may 4, may suspecha na cancer na yon. Okay? Now, kung may cystic mass nakita sa ultrasound, usually hindi nila lalagyan na suspecha for cancer. They will call it benign. Okay? Usually, BI-RADS 3, probably benign, na ang nalagay nila. Na? Yung pag may suspecha na cancer, they label it as BI-RADS 4 right away. At least 4. Okay? So, ito yung illustration na ito yung circumscribed, okay, well-defined margin nakita sa ultrasound, no? Dito naman, nakita nyo yung margin ng bukol, irregular. So, pag irregular ang margin, suspect cancer. Pag maganda yung margin, they don't suspect cancer. Usually, they will say most likely, most probably, it's benign. Okay? Okay, to repeat, circumscribed, regular, well-defined margin, the ultrasound, so the ultrasonographer will most likely suspect it's benign. But irregular margin, they will suspect cancer. Sa mammography naman, okay, sa mammography, usually ang inahap nito, yung mga cluster of microcalcification. When you say microcalcification, may mga tuldik na puti, yung mga maliliit lang, no? Kasi may mga malalaki na we call that pores, no, probably 2 millimeters, no, yung mga tiny microcalcification less than 1 millimeter, no. Okay, so kung may maliit na yung tuldik na calcification, maliliit, saka may cluster, let's say mga 5 in one area, then we suspect breast in mammography there's a suspicion for breast cancer. Hindi lang isa. Pag may isang maliit na tuldik, they don't suspect breast cancer. Okay? Dapat may cluster. So, and then, kuminsan, may nakikitang mass density kasi may bukol na. And then, there's a speculated border. So, sorry for the wrong spelling here. SPI dapat ito. Speculated border. Okay? Meaning, yung border, just like sa ultrasound, hindi siya well-defined. No? Fuzzy and spiky. No? I will show an illustration on this. No? Speculated border. Meron silang nakitang puti na density, most likely that's the mass, kitang-kita na yung bukol, no? Okay? And then, yung border, merong speculations. Ito yun, no? Itong illustrations of microcalcifications, ng maliliit na puting tuldik, no? Cluster, sama-sama, okay? Okay. In contrast to macro, ayo, macro is malaki, no? Okay? This is usually benign. Now, this one, you suspect cancer already. Microcalcification at cluster. Yung pulong-pulong, sama-sama yung ano. Okay. Ito, malaking microcalcifications, marami. So, it's a non-cancer suspect. Ito, maliliit na microcalcifications, may cluster. Then, the cancer is a suspect here. So dito naman, kung meron kang density nakita sa breast, no, kasi may bukol na, malaking may bukol na talaga. So pag well circumscribed and border, no, benign pa rin, no. So sometimes may mga variations, obscured siya, microlobulated, indistinct. Pero pagdating dito, speculated border, malamang the suspect for breast cancer is about 90 more than 95 already. More than 95% sure na yun. No? Okay. When you have microlobulated, indistinct, magsususpect pa rin sila ng cancer, pero it's not as high as the one with speculations. No? So, what are the confirmatory diagnostic procedures after suspicion for breast cancer? Okay. in these various scenarios, after a breast self exam, after a physician physical exam, after the imaging procedures. So, after a breast self exam, let's say kayong kumapa at meron kayong nakitang solid, okay, non-tender, dominant mass, okay, pupunta na kayo kagad sa isang doktor. Okay? So the patient should be evaluated by a physician, particularly a breast specialist. Ang breast specialist in the Philippines, strictly speaking, ang mga breast surgeon. Okay? So, but when you say breast surgeon, that doesn't mean the surgeon would always operate on you, no? Okay. So to tell you a background story on this one, okay? Ang specialist dito sa Pilipinas, as I said, usually ang general surgeon, no? Basta yung may title na general surgeon, hindi nila in-specify na breast surgeon sila, but these are the specialists who have training in breast, lahat ng breast conditions. So sila ang pinakamaraming years of training sa breast cancer, iba mga breast diseases, iba-iba, no? Okay? Kaya strictly speaking, yung general surgeons are usually the breast specialists, no? Okay. So we know that kahit na specialist siya, hindi man niya kaya lahat, no? So kuminsan kung kailangan ibang gamutan, like chemotherapy, then i-refer na lang niya sa isang medical oncologist, no? Or sometimes kung meron siyang may mga doctor na so-called breast surgical oncologist, yung mga general surgeons nag-specialize sa breast cancer, and then sometimes they also do chemotherapy, so pwedeng i-refer sa kanila. They are also called breast specialists, na? Okay. So, after a physician physical examination naman, kung may suspecha yung doctor na breast cancer, anong gagawin niya? Okay. So meron siyang options, no? This is just after the physical examination. May options siya, pwede siyang gumawa ng ultrasound, no? Let's say may nakita siyang solid breast tumor, no? Non-tender, ill-defined mass. Ang suspecha lang naman is about 60%. So medyo hindi pa sigurado. So most likely papa-ultrasound niya, no? So just to get more information, no? Okay. Or at times he or she would order mammography lang, no? Or sometimes a combination of ultrasound and mammography. And the other option is to do a needle biopsy, no? So the biopsy can be of two types, no? No, biopsy. Sorry for the wrong spelling, okay? So it could either be a fine needle biopsy. When you say fine needle biopsy, yung ginagamit lang yung parang ordinary needles na sa hiringilya, no? So yung nakikita natin na mga syringes with needle na ginagamit sa injection, sa mga gamot, no? Okay. And then core needle used as special instruments, no? Okay. Mas malaki yung cryum nito at usually mas malaking makukuha ng sample, no? So, then after the imaging procedures and ultrasound mammography has been done, wala pang mammography, ngayon kung may suspecha na breast cancer sa ultrasound and mammography, the next option will be pwedeng gawin yung biopsy, no? Fine needle or core needle biopsy. Biopsy with cytologic or histopathologic findings usually has last say in the diagnosis. So usually ang pinakamabigat nito will be the biopsy, no? And two types of biopsy, cytologic. Yung fine needle, sinabi ko kanina, usually they study the cells lang. That's why it's called cytologic. Now, yung core needle, no, pag ginawa yung core needle, mas malaking sample makukuha, they study the whole tissue and they call it histopathologic report or biopsy or reports. No? Usually, pag merong nagsabi ng itong report na may cancer, usually yun yon. Medyo final na siya, no? Medyo, ha? But not in all cases, no? Kumisa, hindi pa rin, may instances, hindi pa rin sigurado, no? So, possible results of the biopsy will be the following, either cytologic or histopathologic reports, which minsan sasabihin niya, no malignant cells or malignancy seen. So, okay yon. So, sa isang pasyente, pag walang nakita, no? then they would sometimes say suspicious, especially for the fine needle biopsy. Sabi nila, may suspecha, may suggestive, may consistent, then definitely with breast cancer. No? So yan ang mga possible results of biopsy na makukuha natin from a pathologist. Okay. So I guess that's the last slides for this particular topic. No? So I'd like to repeat again what I just talked about. Okay, the contents will be when to suspect the presence of breast cancer after you do your breast self-exam, after a physician's examination, after an ultrasound, and after a mammography, and what are the confirmatory diagnostic procedures after suspicion for breast cancer. So you can do after breast self-examination, pupunta sa doctor, bahala yung doctor na mag-decide what to do. After a physician physical examination, again, it's up to the doctor to decide whether to do a ultrasound, mammography, or biopsy. And after an imaging procedure such as ultrasound, mammography, the next step kung meron pang gagawin, usually biopsy na. No? Okay. These are the confirmatory diagnostic procedures. So takeaway in relation to patient empowerment. Be always in touch with reliable medical information on breast cancer when to suspect. Knowledge is power. It gives power. Use the 4 Ks of patient empowerment: kaalaman, kakayanan, karapatan, and kapangyarihan. To gain greater control over decisions and make better decisions on breast cancer when to suspect as part of your health management. This ends my pep talk today. I hope I have empowered you to have an essential understanding of breast cancer when to suspect as part of your health management. Before we go to the question and answer portion, reminder, please take the online learning cum evaluation test exercise for mastery of learning and have a perfect score to get a certificate like this shown here. I have placed the link in the chat box. And then reminder again, 25 obtaining 25 Poleto certificates will entitle one mentee to a voucher for a RO Hoson medical consultation. And then please type in your feedback in the chat box before we adjourn. And then let's now have a group picture taking before we start the QA interactions. Please turn on your video now. So, clear ba yung ano ka? Lecture ko? May naputol pa ba yung sound? Okay na? Okay.
Okay naman do.
Okay. Was it clear, the sound system? Naririnig niyo ako?
Yes, Doc.
Abet?
Yes. Yeah. It's clear. Yeah, I can hear you.
Abet, hindi kita naman.
I can hear you.
Okay, kanina, okay yung sound system all the way?
Yes. Okay. Yeah, all the way.
Okay, thank you. So let's now have a group picture taking. One, two. Okay. Pahabo si Maria Hosta Polotan. Wala. Maria Hosta Polotan calling Beijing. Okay, wala. One, two. Okay. Oh, dumating na si Maria. Okay, let's take it again. Oh, si Mary Ann naman nawala. Okay. Oh, sige, okay na. Okay, the floor is now open for questions, comments, okay, sharing of experiences, as well as for questions for consultations if you have any. Okay. Questions? Susan? Yeah, I saw the hand of Susan.
Go ahead. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. Okay, loud and clear.
Okay. Well, I'll talk about my case. You know it very well.
Sure.
5 years ago, it started with 5 or 6 hip pains. Then after 2 years, I don't do exam, no? Hindi ako marunong noon.
Press
So,
up,
well,
yeah.
after 2 years, after 2 years, ang sakit-sakit ng left breast ko, I went to a regular doctor. Sabi, mastitis,
Okay.
no? So, and then eventually, as I told you, nagkaroon ng blood discharge sa nipples. So
Okay.
that's when I was natakot ako. I went to see you finally, no?
Okay.
And then you did breast exam, and then you told me sana sinabi ko ka ano sana pinuntahan kita kagad because of the blood discharge, no? And then you asked me to do core needle biopsy, and then you went over it, and then sinabi may mga options ko, and apparently I had to do to have ano ba to, surgery, no?
Okay.
Then after surgery, you told me na based on the ano that sa PGH naman yun, no ano ba to, no recurrence, clinical evidence of recurrence. That means it didn't recur, but there was cancer, right?
No. No. I mean, sige, mag-explain ko. I-explain ko. Oh, tuloy mo lang.
Yeah, okay. Namastectomy yung left, okay? Tinanggal. And tinanggal yung, I think, you remove 2 solid masses, tapos, ewan ko kung may nakita pa sa lymph nodes. And then, okay, what I only remembered is that you told me no clinical evidence of recurrence. So there was breast cancer, but it didn't recur. Is that a right interpretation of mine, of what you said?
Okay, you're done.
Yes, doc.
Okay. I don't think. Okay, probably you misunderstood me about the word recurrence. No, recurrence. No, we don't talk about
Yeah.
recurrence during the time of the operation. Okay, we only talk about
Okay.
recurrence after an operation. Okay, so yung sa
Okay.
iyo,
Yes.
when I operated on you, no. I should not be talking about a recurrence unless you have previous surgery before me, which you did not have, right? You did not have previous surgery before.
I have wala wala of the ano
Of the breast, of the
of the no wala
breast. Okay, nga.
oh
We only talk about recurrence after an operation. This time, in this
yeah, it was
case,
after an operation.
after the operation. No, when you say after, usually. Months, years after, not right after. Okay. Okay.
Okay.
So
Yes.
probably you misunderstand. So when they say no evidence, I don't think I said recurrence. Ano bang sinabi ko? No
No,
evidence.
no clinical evidence of recurrence.
During the checkup na. Okay. That's usually my
Yeah, then of course.
okay. That's usually my
Mali lang yung aking ano, oo.
Pag nagpapa-check up yung mga pasyente sa akin after the operation, no, I must have a conclusion, di ba? Like my conclusion is my diagnosis.
Okay.
So my diagnosis is always usually at the end of the visit, I usually tell you at this time no evidence of recurrence. Okay? Okay.
Okay.
So
Okay.
hindi yung sa histopath, hindi yung pa yung sa histopath,
Ay,
no.
hindi. No, not on.
Okay, so that's okay. That in that case, you're correct, no? So I thought I mentioned to you recurrence during the time of the biopsy, no? Ganon, hindi, no? It's after
No,
the
no, no.
checkup.
After the operation.
Okay, during the checkup, no? Okay, so that's clear na, no? That's clear, no?
Okay.
So,
Okay.
okay, ano pa yung concern mo? Yung biopsy. Okay.
Na-biopsy naman ako, pero yung ano, operahan na mastectomy, And I went to you, ha? Ilang visits ako sa iyo, tapos yung last sinabi mo sa akin, no clinical evidence of recurrence. Tama.
Yeah, that's usually because usually my policy is that I usually follow up my patients for the rest of her life or my life. Kung sinong mauna. Okay? Kung mauna ako, ipapasok ko kayo sa anak ko. Okay? So, importante yung check-up.
Magkasing edad tayo.
Hindi nga, kung sinong nauna. Kasi it's always possible it could recur, no? It could recur. Pero yung sa iyo, if I look at your specific case, iba-iba kasing kaso ng ibang pasyente, no? Yung sa iyo, to tell you honestly, para ma-console ka rin, no? Na it's not something very yung din naman prognosis is not bad, no? Very good, no? Maliit ang chance na magre-recur, no? Pero there's still a small percentage it might recur, kaya importante ang check-up. And then when you come for check-up, usually my conclusion when I examine you, sasabihin ko sa iyo, no evidence of recurrence at this time, the check-up. Na? Okay?
Okay, ma'am. Okay. So that's it. So 1 year na ako do after the operation. Ang operation ko was July 29, 2023.
Good.
1 year na ako, but I still have to see you. I still have to see you one of these days.
Yeah. Okay.
When you are not busy.
Yeah, I collect my 25 ano mo. Olete certificates mo. Malapit na.
Masipag akong mag-olete.
Malapit ka mag 25 olete certificates.
Masipag akong mag-olete.
Para may libreng consultation ka na. Okay. So let's go pa. Application, no? So first time that you saw a patient several years ago before you saw me, yung sinagsabi mastitis, no? Mastitis.
Yeah.
So anong nare-recall mo? Nare-recall mo kung anong nararamdaman mo? Masakit lang?
Masakit, parang namamaga.
Okay. So ang based on my lecture, hindi yung suspect for breast cancer, no?
Hindi. Masakit,
nagmasakit, pwedeng mapula, mastitis.
Yeah.
Okay? Pagbukol, pag may bukol at walang sakit na solid, ayun, magsuspect ka na ng cancer, no? Okay. If that be the case, to everybody, when you see such a situation, puntahan na ninyo yung doktor, huwag niyo yung ano, no? So, pwede niyo i-observe for up to 1 month, baka pwede pa. After 1 month, kung andyan pa, dapat patingin na kayo, no? Okay? Huwag niyo palatalain. Kasi I'm always depressed and sad when I see a lot of patients coming to me, advanced na, no? Yung pumuputok na, no? Ang hirap tulungan na, no? Ganon. So that's the reason why I'm trying to the reason for this particular lecture also, that's the reason behind. Ang dami kasing pasyente ako nakikita, advanced na, it's either they don't know when to suspect breast cancer o talaga denial, ayaw nila paggamot,
in denial.
Or they rely too much on alternative medicine which are not which has only 1% effectiveness, di ba? Ganon, no? Ganon. So yun ang reason, no? So yung the next one is nipple discharge. Yung nipple discharge po, was it a little bloody?
Bloody na. Oh, bloody na.
So bloody, okay. That's the alarming part na, di ba? A little bloody, no?
Yeah.
Pero kung saan nawawala na tayo, I remember nawawala, hindi ba? Tama? Nawawala.
Yeah, pero nung ipalpate mo, bloody pa rin eh.
Oo. Anyway, okay. It's not, hindi ma talagang bloody na bloody, hindi ba? Okay. Natatanda. Yeah, pero may suspect na rin. No? And then there is a, ang importante doon, may bukol ako nakakapa, hindi ba?
Okay. Yes. Dalawa pa nga.
Yun nga. So that's the starting application of this lecture, no? Is that we suspect already possible cancer, di ba? Okay. So that's why we do a lot of tests. We did a core needle biopsy, no? After that core needle biopsy, ang labas naman, di siya clear cut na cancer, di ba? May atypical something, di ba? Atypical. Yan ang kasama sa lecture ko, di ba? Yung mga possible results that can come out, not sure of the findings. So it's really up to the breast specialist to decide what to do next. Huh? Okay. So of course, with explanation and informed consent from the patient and the relatives. So we decided on doing a biopsy, di ba? Ay, removal of the tumor na, no? Para once and for all, masettle na. Okay?
Yes.
Kasi the other options that I gave you, i-observe lang natin, pero we don't know how long and up to anong end point, di ba? So ngayon, so back most likely mas kampante ka na, no? Okay?
Yeah. And you did not really tell me to do chemo. So hindi na ako, wala namang chemo.
Okay. Yeah, okay. Yung sa iyo, I think nasa borderline ka, most likely sa borderline ka na. Yung cancer, kasi there are various degrees of cancer. Merong mga aggressive na cancer, merong mga aggressive, no? So yung sa iyo, most likely aggressive, kaya sinabi ko sa iyo, saka lymph nodes mo were negative, so sabi ko sa iyo, observe na lang natin, no? Okay? Okay?
Yeah.
Final decision usually rests on, number one, not totally on the clinician, breast specialist like me, but also with consultation of the patient's wish. Di ba? Ganon.
Yeah. Is it possible, Doc, that there will be another cancer in the right breast na hindi naman na-opera?
Pwede. Pwede. As long as we are, number one, as long as we are alive in this world, any disease can occur, okay? And then, if you have organs with two sides, let's say kidney, two sides with left and right kidney, di ba? Breast, two kidneys, eyes, dalawa, may isang pair, di ba? So it doesn't when you have one problem on one side, let's say the breast, no, it's possible that you may have another one on the other side. Huh? Okay. Okay. Kasi,
One last, kidney,
di ba? Kidney, you have one cancer on one side, inoperahan mo, there'll always the question na baka magkaroon ako sa kabila. Pwede rin. Yeah, kaya lang, hindi mahirap na tanggalin ng dalawang kidney, mamamatay yung pasyente. Yung sa breast, pwede pa. Okay. One last
point, Doc.
Sige.
Before I let you, yung left ko nga ang naoperahan, no? Kuminsan, every now and then, nakakaramdam ako ng parang namimintig yung left arm ko. Is it related to the operation or baka naman hindi?
Most likely it's related to most likely it's related now kasi the mere fact we operated on you kasi if I did not operated on you or no operation was done sasabihin ko sa iyo it's not related, di ba? Logic na to. But since I operated on you, meron tayong may ginawa tayo doon, may kinat tayo doon, most likely related, no? It's still when you create those things still part of number one, side effect of the operation or it's still baka may ongoing healing process pa. No? Okay, yung healing process matagal 'yon, usually mga years, no? Yung mga sa loob hindi lang natin nakikita, no? Okay.
Okay.
Try to recall, try to para for you to better understand yung sinabi ko ni last one, yung years and years of healing, may nakikita kang scar, yung scar now 1 year after hindi pa masyadong maganda, di ba? 10 years after, hindi mo napapansin, di ba? So, it shows that there's constant healing going on. No? Okay?
Okay? Thank you, Doc. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you also for bringing all those things up for great discussions. I hope with Susan's sharing, or may kasamang consult na the other mentees attending here are benefiting from her questions, no? And from my answers also, I hope. Okay. So any more questions, comments, sharing.
Hi, Doc Rochelle. I'm sorry.
Sino?
That's all right.
Sige, Rochelle. Oh, nakita ako, Rochelle.
Okay, good afternoon po. So, follow up lang po ang question sa case po ni Miss Susan. You can hear me, okay, Doc?
Oh, yeah, I can.
So, follow up lang po sa case ni Miss Susan. Yung sa kanya po kasi start with a fibrocystic condition or fibrocystic changes. Breast. So, ano po yung, mataas po ba talaga yung probability or yung likelihood na once you have fibrocystic breast, magde-develop into cancer?
Oh, saan mo nabasa yon? Nabasa mo?
Hindi po. Kasi po, ang condition ko po, meron po akong fibrocystic breast condition eh. Every time po, follow up po ako ng quest ng check up po sa iyo. Palagi pong ganun yung findings niyo sa akin sa well at least sa breast. So, mataas doc ang probability or yung likelihood na once meron kang fibrocystic breast condition eventually magiging cancer?
Okay, before I answer directly your questions, kasi tinanong kita kung saan mo nabasa 'yon, 'di ba? Okay. Kasi may historical background dyan do sa tanong ko, no? Okay. So, when in the past, pero up to now may mga doctors, may mga centers na may mga breast specialists pa rin naniniwala doon sa they call it fibrocystic disease, no? Okay. And then some would still consider that kasi dati-dati during my earlier years, although hindi ako naniniwala, pero during examination dapat sunurin ko yung kung anong tamang sagot na gusto ng doktor, ng teacher namin, di ba? Sinasabi nila fibrocystic changes has a risk for breast cancer, di ba? So yun ang historical background, no? But nowadays, now if you read the kaya ako tinatanong kung nasa mo na basa, I know all of us are reading or nag-google tayo, di ba? Okay, maraming information tayo nakukuha. Now, nowadays when you read when you search the internet, no, sa Mayo Clinic, sa Cleveland Clinic, I'm glad that they always emphasize that fibrocystic changes is not a risk factor for development of breast cancer, no? So at least that validate na yung aking belief dati, no? So to answer your question, no, fibrocystic changes, no, does not increase your risk for breast cancer, no? So yan ang answer ko sa tanong mo, no? Pero another input ibigay ko sa inyong lahat because most of you are my patients, no? Okay. So you have dumanda kayo sa akin, no? Each doctor has its own way of treating patients and also may kanya-kanyang language sila, di ba? Iba-iba, di ba? Okay. Yung sa akin, when I examine your breast, my approach is, but kung wala akong, okay. Rochelle, wala ka sa lecture last time, no? When we say breast cancer is, when breast is normal, ando ka ba?
Wala po, Doc.
Okay.
Wala po, Doc. Sorry.
Pero nabasa, okay, nabasa mo yung, ano, yung proceedings naman, okay? Anyway, basahin mo na lang,
yes,
ha?
Yes, Doc.
Okay. So, pag wala akong nakit, something to suspect a disease, I call it normal just by palpation, di ba? Just by examination, no? But you also know that hindi ako basta-basta nag-order mga lab exams kung di kailangan, no? Okay? So that's my way of doing things, no? Okay. So pag wala akong nakitang suspecha for a particular disease, sasabihin ko sa iyo normal, di ba? Logical naman yun, di ba? Normal, no?
Apo.
Now, kaya lang, I don't know when it started. Then, baka 20 years ago, I started adding the word fibrocystic changes, no? Okay, aside from telling a patient, normal ka, wala kang problema sa suso mo, sa kapa ko, at least, di ba? Pero, after so many years, dinagdagan ko na yung fibrocystic changes. And you also look remember my slides kanina, no, yung may picture, no, na may illustrations, humpy lumpy breast, no, fibrocystic changes, and then normal, no. Okay, So the reason why I started using fibrocystic changes, no, to advise to the patient na normal siya, but I call it fibrocystic changes or hormonal changes, kasi pumasok na yung mga ultrasound, di ba? So ultrasound, kahit na normal ka sa kapwa mo, maraming nakikita, no? Maraming nakikita at sasabihin nila may mga bukol-bukol, but in the end, a lot of them will just tell you probably benign, probably benign. And a lot of them, kahit na sinabi mo, pag sinabi sa ultrasound, may bukol, wala ka namang makapa. No? Okay? So that drove me to use the word fibrocystic changes para madaling i-explain to pasyente. Kasi pag sinabi kong normal, eh kayo naman kasi kadalasan kahit na hindi kailangan, nagpapa-ultrasound kayo, okay, mga doctor, ultrasound lahat, may mga promo-promo, ultrasound, ultrasound, maraming lumalabas na alarming, di ba? Sasabihin nila, bukol, bukol, bukol. Pero kadalasan sasabihin din nila, probably benign. Pero pag kinapa mo, wala talagang bukol, di ba? So, for me to explain the yung differences in my diagnosis, na sabi ko normal, no? Yung sinasabi sa ultrasound, may mga bukol, I started using the phrase fibrocystic changes, no? Para ma-explain ko sa kanila yung findings sa ultrasound, no? Pag yung ultrasound, may lumabas na may bukol, na may dalawang component na isa cystic, di ba? May mga cystic changes, bukol, they call it nodules also. Isa naman, solid, no? Okay? Pero yung solid na yun, pag di mo nakakapa, yun ang fibrous part of the fibrocystic. No? Fibrous part of the fibrocystic. No? Okay. Fibrous part of... Okay. I was just distracted. Somebody passed by. So, fibrocystic. No? So, yan ang sinasabi ko sa mga pasyente. Kaya ako sinasabing fibrocystic. Tinuturo sa kanila. Sa ultrasound, yun, nakita mo the word cystic. Yan ang sinasabi ng bukol ng mga radiologist. No? And then, meron mga solid masses pero hindi mo nakakapa. Yun ang fibrous. Actually, hindi sila talagang bukol. Because ultrasound kasi uses sound waves. No? Pag sound waves, tinitingnan nila kung ano yung makapal, bumabarandra, ganun-ganun. No? Pero pag merong hypoechoic means kokonti yung echo, sasabihin nila bukol, they call it bukol, but actually it's not bukol, no? Okay. So actually I'm preparing for another lecture. Palagi ko nang sinasabi ko na ito sa mga pasyente at I think I already had some lectures before. I probably two Saturdays from now I will be repeating another lecture entitled Physical Exam Diagnosis and Ultrasound Diagnosis, no? How to Reconcile the Differences. Kasi maraming may variations, maraming interpretations, no? So that's it, no? Normal siya, yung sa'yo, when I say fibrocystic changes, Rochelle, or to the others, when I use that word, it's the same as normal, no? Ginagamit ko lang that term for me to be able to explain to you adequately yung ultrasound na ginagawa sa inyo. Okay? Okay? Okay, Rochelle?
Salamat. Salamat po, Doc.
Thank you for the questions. Susan, ikaw na.
Sir, can I ask you? Okay.
Sino? Can I add? Sinong add? Sinong nag-
I'm going to ask a question.
Sige, Arvin.
Okay. Ma'am Susan first.
Ako? Okay. Doc, kasi I'm your patient now, di ba? Parang the physical monitoring, yung touch, did not qualify on me. I don't know kasi hindi ako professional, not like you na pro in doing it. Ano. So, parang ako nun, kasi maliit pa siya, so hindi ko na-detect, di ba? So, I had, tapos yun nga, it was detected by a mammogram and ultrasound. So now the question is, now that after my surgery with you, I am on a regular consultation with you every 2 months. So doon meron naman akong peace of mind kasi namo-monitor mo po whatever changes meron sa body ko. So after kung hindi ko po alam kung hanggat kailan ako every 2 months with you for the consultation para lang may monitoring. Aside from that, kung hindi po ako mag-physical self-touch sa breast ko, will I be needing an annual or a regular mammo or ultrasound, or I'll just have to see you often or on your decision of when to see you to monitor my condition? Yun lang po, Doc.
Okay. So, okay. Ano bang first issue? Yung first issue, yung sa'yo, yung na-discover sa'yo na breast cancer, it was discovered incidentally by yung annual mammo ba and ultrasound?
Physical exam.
No.
Mammo and ultrasound.
Mammo, ultrasound, not physical exam, di ba? Okay.
Tama.
Okay, ultrasound and mammo. So, it's, as I told you last time, na yung there's a limit to everything. It's a physical exam. You can only palpate a mass, no, that is mga 1 centimeter more or less, no? Okay? But if it's less than 1 centimeter, usually hindi mo makakapayo na kung breast cancer, no?
So,
ultrasound and mammo will be able to catch it at that smaller sizes, di ba? Okay, smaller sizes.
Okay.
Now, that's the advantage of the ultrasound and mammo. They can catch it in the earlier stage. Mm-hmm. No? But the issue is, okay, as I said, may kanya-kanyang advantage, disadvantage. Ang disadvantage ng advantage ng mammo ultrasound, they can catch it in the stages na maliit pa sa 1 centimeter, no? Na hindi pa nakakapa, no? Pero pag ginawa mo yung lahat, if you want to catch that, kung objective mo is to catch that very, very small tumor, you have to do annual at least, no? Okay, mammo ultrasound for the rest of your life. O kung saan, at certain, para to be cost-effective, sinasabi nila na you do it only when you are at the high-risk level, no? Kasi kung to do it routinely, no? From 40 up to 80, 90, hindi mo kakayanin din yon, di ba? May advantage. So, hindi mo kakayanin yon at hindi kaya suportahan ng gobyerno. Kaya walang program ng ganon na libre, di ba? In other countries, may mga libreng mammography, no? Ganon, no? Pero they limit it to certain stages lang, no? Sa Europe, they start at 50 up to mga 75, baka 70 lang, but more than 70 hindi na nila ginagawa, no? Okay. So ang sinasabi nila, yung cost effectiveness. Kung gagawin mo lahat, konti lang makakatch mo, no? Okay, it's true, you can catch it early, pero konti lang makakatch mo. And then, ang kapalit nun, yung mga expenses mo, no? Yung high cost of doing things, no? Okay? So, yung sa yours, okay? So, they just call it, you're fortunate, nakita, di ba? Okay? So, pero kasi pwede ding false negative yon, false positive. No, it just so happened it turned out to be positive, no? Okay. So kung sinabing negative, no, di kampante ka pa rin, di ba? Kung sinabing positive binayopsi ka, no, turn out to be negative, magiging false positive siya. So you underwent an operation, no, which strictly speaking, they can consider that as unnecessary. Okay? Ganon. Basta yung mga issues ng false positivity, false negativity issues will come in. No? At any rate, tanggapin mo na lang na you were able to discover it early, okay? Fortunately, and then you underwent the operation, no? With good prognosis, no? So, now comes the surveillance, no? Kasi proven cancer ka na, you have proven cancer.
Okay.
We have to do the surveillance. When you do the surveillance is monitoring for recurrences. Yung pinag-usapan namin ni Susan kanina, recurrences,
okay.
No? Recurrences, it's usually for life, okay? Because a cancer, we never talk about cure for cancer. Sa medical world, we don't talk about cure, no? But ako, sometimes I will tell you honestly, if you are 30 years old, naka 30 years ka na, more or less cured ka na, no? Ganon, no? Formally, no doctor will tell you that you are cured. They will say, you are in remission. You are in remission. Walang evidence of recurrence, but always the possibility may magre-recur. O kaya hindi lang nakikita. No? Ganon. No? So surveillance is usually for life. No? Okay. Now, so last two issues to your questions, we can do it two schools of thoughts. One, in terms of surveillance approaches, one is tinatawag na symptom sign-based surveillance. The other one is battery of tests. A battery of tests being done, mga diagnostic tests being done on you. No? Okay. So the first one is based on symptoms. Kung meron kang nararamdaman, I usually ask the questions. You have symptoms of distant recurrence like protracted or long period of headache, long period of joint bone pain, long period of cough, long period of abdominal pain. Now, these are the four areas of recurrence, yung distant, yung sa pain, sa lungs, sa bone, sa liver. No? Yeah, I ask those questions. Kung meron kang symptoms, any of those symptoms, then we investigate right away. No? Okay. Then kung sa sign naman, the sign means when I examine you. No? When I examine your breast, no? Yung at least the seven parts, no? So right breast, left breast, then right and left armpit, then the sa neck, dalawa, and then sa abdomen, pito, pang pito, no? Okay? Seven parts, no? Okay? Ngayon, kung meron akong nakitang suspecha, then I do the test, no? Okay? Now, the other school of thoughts, yung isang test naman, yung battery of test, gagawin lahat yung ano mo, mammography, gagawin yung mga ultrasound mo, brain scan, bone scan, and then CT scan, lahat, gagawin, no? Okay, yun ang battery of test, no? But a lot of studies have shown that it's not really needed, no? Kasi hindi siya cost-effective. So maraming negative. Ang makakatch mo na lang, isa, dalawa, it's not worth the expense. For it, kasi either, kung mayaman ka, kung gusto ka, you believe that you want to be, to do that, okay lang, no? Okay? Pero for the government or any institution to finance it, hindi nila gagawin yon, no? Okay? Now, in terms of yung interval, as I said, for life, no? Yung interval sa ngayon, ang policy ko is every 2 months, dati-dati every month, ginawa ko ng every 2 months na lang, no? For the first year. Then after that, on the second year, kahit na every 3 months na, no? Okay. Then pag umabot ka ng 5 years, no, it all depends on the physician's belief and perception on ano. O kaya kumisan, it also depends on your chances of recurrence, no, at yung distance, yung residence. Kung malayo kang inuuwian, if you still want me to have to check you up, then we will adjust, di ba? We will adjust, no? Okay. So with the presence of telemedical consultation, pwede nang ano, pero mas maganda pa rin ang kapa-kapa sa breast, di ba? Yung kapaan, no?
Yes.
Hirap mag-telemedical, no? So usually, okay, naka 5 years ka na, probably, at most, kasi as I said, cancer can recur anytime, no? So some would suggest right now, check up once every year, after the 5th year, after the 6th year, some would say every 2 years, after the 10th year, ganun-ganun, no? Okay. Ako, ang personal opinion ko, with the assumption that it can recur anytime, and then with the assumption that yung mga pasyente hindi cannot get, as I said, as you said, yung wala kang expertise, di ba? Expertise to debate. Sabihin ko lang, every 6 months will be safest.
Okay.
Pag umabot ka ng 5 years, pag umabot ka ng 5 years, na? So, okay?
Yes, thank you, Doc, for the answer.
Okay. Sinong nag-abet ikaw, anong tanong?
I'm just going to ask if fibroadenoma is a benign finding of breast mass. Can a fibroadenoma be a cancer in the long time or in the long run? Can it be cancer also?
Theoretically, anything is possible in this world. Nothing is perfect. Theoretically, pwede. But realistically, yung in actual practice, I've not seen one na fibroadenoma becoming a cancer. Na kung fibroadenoma, talagang fibroadenoma. Kung in the future, ay sabihin mo, there's a incident na parang a cancer related to the previous operation, babalikan mo yung diagnosis na yung during the first time. Baka mali siya. Mali ang diagnosis. Baka cancer pala. No? Ganon. No? So once you have fibroadenoma, kung siguradong-sigurado ka na fibroadenoma, sabihin natin, let's say 20, 25 years old female, pagkatapos yung cross examination ng tumor based on the surgeon's experience, and then meron siyang histopath na fibroadenoma, 99% na fibroadenoma, hindi siya magiging cancer. Now, it can recur, pero hindi siya, it can recur as a fibroadenoma, pero hindi siya magre-recur as a cancer. Na? Iba yun. Na? Okay? Any more questions? Susan?
Wala na do.
Ah, okay, kasi nakita ko yung lips. Nakita ko yung lips mo eh, hindi nagsasalita. Mute ka eh. Okay. So any more comments? Wala na? Lance, would you like to make a last comment? My son, Lance.
Ayun, hello.
Oh, yeah.
Regarding lang dun sa fibroadenoma, ayun, kasi nga nag-ano dito sa Singapore, nagtatrain, napansin ko yung sa kanila, basta proven na fibroadenoma, tapos parang minomonitor lang nila for 2 years, kung wala naman change in growth or stable yung size ng mass, di na nga nila, parang di na nila pina-follow up eh. Parang dinidischarge na lang, tapos routine screening na lang. Mostly nga parang hindi na rin nila ina-advise na to undergo surgery kung hindi naman lumalaki yung mass, saka proven na fibroadenoma. Parang confident na sila na wala siyang chance of malignancy dito.
Any size, Lance?
Walang size cutoff eh. Parang may nakita ako mga 3 cm fibroadenoma, hindi rin nila parang outright na tinatanggal. Parang they just monitor it for 2 years. Kung walang change, they just don't touch it. Kasi...
How do we apply it sa Philippines?
So parang very low chance, yeah.
Yeah, very low chance nga, pero how do you apply it? Yung kay Jeng, kita mo kay Jeng, ganun kay Jeng, natandaan ko si Jeng, fibroadenoma kay Jeng, di ba? So, maliit lang naman yun sa kanya. So, first time we operate. Ilang beses ba kita inoperate?
Yeah,
Jeng?
Once lang po.
So, but before I operated on you, I gave you a period of observation, di ba? Ino-observe natin until such a time na, sige, tanggalin na natin, di ba? Okay. So after tinanggal, may umulit naman sa ibang parte, di ba? Okay. So umulit, in-observe na lang natin, di ba? So ilang years na natin ino-observe? 10 years na?
Almost 12 na po, Doc.
Almost 12 years. Okay. That's an application of what?
So, yung left side, yung last natin nga yung March na nagpa-check up po ako sa inyo, wala na po talaga yung mas na nakakapan nyo sa left dati. Pero yung sa right, meron pa rin po, pero pa-small. Kaya sabi nyo, pag na, sa age ko, kasi 50 na ako, pag nawala na ako ng menstruation, siguro po, mas liliyaw. Dok, nawawala na. Hindi na ako. May mata ako hindi nagkakaroon.
Okay.
Eh, by September naman po, may check ulit ako sa inyo.
Okay. So, gamitin mo rin free consultation mo. Okay.
Yes po.
Okay. So, yun, no? Yung fibroadenoma. Okay, I just don't, Now, how we can apply it? Kimisan, what do you call that? I have to reconcile with what the other doctors are doing, no? Kasi ako, I tend to be conservative sa fibroadenoma unless, when I say conservative, ayoko operahan until talagang malaki. But ang question is, ano yung cut-off sa malaki? Di ba? So, some would say 4 centimeters tanggalin. No? Kung less than 4, pwedeng bantayan. May mga guidelines yan eh. Di ba? 4, no? Pero sa
Opo, Philippines... Inopera niyo po ako, 4 centimeters na po yun eh. Kaya po pinatanggal niyo na.
Okay. So, yun nga. No? Pero to some Filipinos, kung isang kahit na 3 centimeters, alarm na sila. Di ba? Takot na sila. No? Kaya kumisan, you just have to give in, no? Kasi kaysa palagi nang iniisip, no? Kasi kahit na sabihin mo, ay, wala namang, ano yan, benign siya. But as a doctor, you cannot assure 100% also, di ba? Okay. So, okay, kung minalas, napunta dun sa 1%, masama pala, sisihin ka pa, no? Sabihin niya, tanggalin na lang yung doktor, di ba? You know, tanggalin na lang nyo, no? So anyway, everything will boils down to informing the patients what's the score and then trying to appease the patient, to allay their fear, to educate them. And then in the end, a decision will have to be made, no? Okay, by the patient, no? Primarily, no? Of course, yung doctor isusupport niya, no? Yung patient's decision, okay? With, of course, idadagdag niyo yung ano, how, basta i-educate niya yung pasyente, baka mali ang paniwala niya, no? Okay. So gano'n lang. Kasi yan ang kahirapan ng maging doktor din, eh. No? Okay. So I'm happy that Singapore is doing that, no? Okay. Okay. Any more
Doc, can I ask a question?
Sinong, Marianne?
Ako po, Doc. Yes, Doc. Balis, Doc, naalala ko dati yung oncologist ko sa Singapore, sa Raffles Hospital. Sabi niya sa akin kasi after my operation, that was in 2013, less na daw ang chances ko mag-recur yung cancer. Kasi nga, nag-menopause ka agad ako in 2014. Bali, di ko maalala, may sinasabi siyang hormones eh. Kaya huwag daw ako ganong matakot kasi nga nag-menopause na daw ako. Paano ba yun, Doc? Hindi ko na maalala yung term na ginamit niya eh.
Ano? Baka yun yung ano, yung estrogen receptor, progesterone
yun nga, Doc.
Saka yung HER2. Baka maganda yung ERPR panel niya. Hindi siya yung aggressive type. Kaya binigyan po kayo ng ano, aromatase inhibitor, letrozole, anastrozole.
Hindi ko na po maalala.
Anong iniinom mo?
Tamoxifen.
Wala po, Doc. Ano lang, yung sa Ifern.
Ah, wala kang ini... Ilang... Kailan ka huling na-operan?
2013 po, Doc.
2013. Wala pang 10 years. No?
10 years na po. 2013 eh.
Kaya nga, kasi pag may gamot ka, usually 10 years ang binibigay. So wala kang gamot na... Hormones?
Wala na po, Doc.
Baka. Kahit na for the flat, yung 5 years, wala? Wala kang inom?
Wala. Yung after po daw my operation, 3 years, hanggang 3 years po yung pinitili kong gamot, kaso hindi ko na po maalala eh.
Okay. Anyway, tingnan mo na lang, ibalikan mo na lang ako. Kasi yung sinabi nga ng anak ko, ni Dr. Hoson, na kung baka may breast panel ka, no? Breast panel means yung ERA, PRA, Susan, di ba? ERA, PRA, HER2 new, yun. Okay? Kung ERA, PRA, maganda, positive, maganda ang prognosis, no? Okay. Pero, baka make sure tama yung sinabi, ang quote mo sa kanya, don't worry. No? Sa akin, as I said kanina,
okay.
Once you have breast cancer, there's always a possibility it can recur anytime. No, kahit na gaano katagal na. No? So, kasi doctors do not strictly speaking categorically say cured ka na. Mapapaso lang sila, no? Okay. So usually sasabihin nila, you are in remission. You are in remission. Yan ang pinaka-safest. Pero informally, behind the scene, ako pwede ko sabihin sa isang pasyente, kung naka 30 years na siya, sabi ko, more or less, sabi ko, cured ka na. Pero magpapacheck up ka pa rin. No? Okay.
Ay, okay. Parati po siyang nag-message sa akin sa Facebook.
Na ano siya?
Yung surgeon ko punta kay oncologist ko. Kaya sabi ko po yung mga... Eh, sabi niya, okay naman pala yan. Sabi niya ganun. Parehong in-check po.
Okay. Anong hospital?
Sa Raffles Hospital po.
Kilala mo? Ano pa?
Yung sa pinag-operahan ko po.
Yan nga, sabi mo kay Ray Benjamin Hoson kung anong pangalan niya.
Oo, nakikita ko yun. Private hospital yun dito sa
atin. Yung doctor, yung doctor ni Mary Ann.
Sabi mo po, si Dr. Lynette Ngo, tsaka si, ano ba yun? Alimutan ko isang pangalan ni nasa Facebook. Hindi ko na maalala po isang doktor.
Usually walang crossover kasi yung private at public dito. Sa public hospital kasi ako
walang crossover unlike sa Manila.
Either public or private pa lang dito.
Okay. Any more questions?
Thank you po, Doc.
Sige. I'm glad Dr. Hoson is here to give us new informations. No? So anymore, kung wala na, we'll call it a day. Now, thank you for all your questions, participations. No? So, natutuwa naman kami kung may maraming nagpa-participate. No? Okay. May free consultation pa. No? So we'll call it a day. Next week, ang topic will be medical diagnosis, yung process, how to do a medical diagnosis, no? Okay? So with that, we'll call it a day. We'll see each other next week. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Doc.
Thank you, po, Doc. Happy weekend.
Thank you, Doc. Happy weekend.
Ingat po.
Bye. Tuesday,
Doc.
Yeah. Tuesday. Bye.